Hi everybody, it's me. Welcome to the co-video. This is Dr. Kestler from Lorain County Community College, and I want to give you a little bit of an update with respect to what's going on. A lot's been going on in the past few days. First of all, we'll start with my temperature, and my temperature today is 95.9 degrees Fahrenheit or 35.5 centigrade. All right, let me move on. First thing I want to address today is a good well wish to get well soon wish to Nadia the Tiger in New York, who is infected with COVID-19, and we suspect there might be other animals in New York as well. That remains to be seen, but we wish her a swift recovery. Now, I got to tell you this, that there is no evidence that any household animals can get pets and cats. Cats are in the same family as tigers and lions. There's no evidence that cats can get the disease or that they can give it back. But still, if you are recovering from COVID, if you have the disease right now, you should take caution as to not spread that around. We'll be following on this for the next few days. Nadia is being cared for by veterinarians at Cornell Veterinary School, so she's in good hands. It is not safe to come out yet, but I will tell you it will happen soon. We will be testing soon for antibody tests. They're beginning to start them at various places in the country, and we'll be testing soon, and we'll see if it's safe to come out. There is no evidence, by the way. A lot of people have been asking me, can you get COVID twice? I already did a video on that subject, and we think that the answer is no, and I can say with some confidence that it appears to be no from China. The good news from China is that their epidemic is holding still. They're starting to return to normal, and they're still it's still holding there, and that is really good news. They have little teeny micro flare-ups, but they seem to be controlling it at this point. They need to be vigilant, and they're releasing the controls, and soon they'll be back to normal, hopefully, and they'll be in a better shape to see how to suppress local outbreaks as they occur. They'll get better and better at it. Europe is improving. The number of deaths has been declining in several countries in Europe. In Spain, the recoveries have been, Spain has been pushing the envelope with the number of cases, Italy as well, and they're starting to see better and better results. I put France in here too. I'm not sure that I want to declare that one, completely on the way to being better, but we will see how that goes. All right, I want to talk briefly about another development this week, and that is that for the first time, some researchers at the University of Pittsburgh have shown that neutralizing antibodies for COVID in mice. So they've been able to study mice, and they've been testing this vaccine in mice, and it seems to be working, and it seems to be producing neutralizing antibodies, that is, which can block the antibodies. And that is really good news. Still a ways off before human testing can occur. Over the weekend, there was also I did something about the cytokine storm that occurs, and there was a very curious study, not really a study at all, but a small number of people who were treated with a monoclonal antibody against one of the receptors for HIV, one of the co-receptors. On this slide here, this is one of the slides that I lifted from my students in talking about HIV infection, and you can see there is a molecule called CD4, which is the principal receptor for HIV, and two co-receptors, including CCR5. CCR5 is the molecule that my students study, and what CCR5 and CXCR4 do is they enable inflammatory signals to be sent. And what has occurred in some very seriously ill patients, very small number, They have been treated with a monoclonal antibody that blocks the CCR5 receptor, and they've seen some improvement in those people. Again, I'm talking about four people that have been treated. That monoclonal antibody is against CCR5, and so we think that this might be possibly a good treatment for people who are in the worst of it, the most serious kind of of disease in managing their recovery. And so this might be a big advantage. I'm going to end right there, and I just want to remind you of the good things that are going on right now. One of the best things that's going on right now is all of you staying home, like I am staying home. It is really, really important at this stage that we keep the infection down. I am so impressed with my state. I'm so proud to be from Ohio right now because of the way we've handled this. We have really done an outstanding job of suppressing the number of cases, and I think we're going to be rewarded for it in terms of what goes on. I also heard a nice story, by the way, speaking of find the helpers. Sometimes the helpers need help. And I heard this wonderful story about a social media event going on that people were buying food for the healthcare workers. And all they were saying is, I'd like to order some food. And then, by the way, I'd like to double my order and please send it to the hospital and give it to whoever would like that food. And I think that's a great, great idea. Show them your support. How can we support healthcare workers? By staying home. It really is an important thing, by staying home to keep them out of it. And also, by the way, you ought to not do anything. I've been riding my bike recently, and I'm going to put my helmet on because I want to make sure that I don't have any kind of an accident that requires hospitalization, because I do not want to tax the healthcare system at this point, so that everybody gets to use it that needs to. I want to remind you all, keep being good to each other. Be good to each other, and may you persist like a lentivirus. See if the animals. Oops. All right. Hi there. Hello. Okay, let me just stop the recording here.